In this video, you learn about Harris-Hawks optimization algorithm. Topics covered in this video. First, we have basic details about this bird, that is Harris-Hawks. Up next, what is this algorithm all about and how it is working step by step. Then we have certain phases in this algorithm: exploration phase, exploitation phase, hard and soft roundup. And you can see we have certain mathematical models used in this algorithm for energy level calculation, how we can decrease the energy for the target, and how we can update the position for the each hawk in the search space, and how we can update the position for the target in the search space. First, we have basic introduction about this algorithm. Harris-Hawks optimization algorithm is a nature-inspired population-based algorithm, and this algorithm mimics the different searching strategies and attacking strategies used by Harris-Hawks in the real life, and we can use this algorithm to solve different engineering problems. Basic details about Harris-Hawk: they are medium large bird, and they are also known as dusky hawk, and they hunt in cooperative groups, and their group size is 2 to 7 birds. Wingspan is 103 to 120 centimeter, and length is 46 to 59 centimeter, and an adult male weight you can see and female weight you can see here. They live in semi-open desert, and they can eat medium-sized mammals such as rabbit, mice, squirrel, birds and all. Next is this algorithm step by step. Input for this algorithm is the population size and the max number of iterations. And the output for this algorithm is the best solution and its fitness value. In the first step, we will initialize the population randomly. Here, X represents the position for each candidate, and I represent the number of agents, and N represent the max number of agents. In step 2, we will check this condition, whether the stopping criteria is matched or not. Here, T is the current iteration and this is the max number of iteration. We will check whether current iteration is greater than or equal to maximum number of iteration or not. If stopping criteria is not matched, then step 3. In step 3, we will compute the fitness value for each hawk and select best. In step 4, set rabbit position as the best location of the rabbit, and in step 5, for each hawk position, we will update the energy level and the jump strength for the rabbit, that is the target. In step 6 and 7, you can see we have exploration and exploitation phases, and in step 8, you can see we can update the position for the hawk in the search space by using 4 strategies: soft roundup, hard roundup, soft roundup with progressive rapid dives, and the last one is hard roundup with progressive rapid dives. In the end, we will return the best rabbit location and its fitness value. So first we have the exploration phase. Exploration means searching, and here attacker, that is Harris-Hawks, is searching for the target, that is rabbit. As we know, they hunt in groups, or you can say pack, and their pack member contain 2 to 7 members. So we have a pack of Harris-Hawks. Harris-Hawk, they are the intelligent bird. First, they will trace and detect the prey with their powerful eyes, and if prey not found, they will bait and observe and monitor the region for several hours. In this algorithm, Harris-Hawk is a candidate solution, and rabbit, or you can say the target, is the best candidate solution. Next question is, how Harris-Hawks detect the prey? Harris-Hawks hunt randomly on the certain regions, and they can bait for the several hours to detect the prey. Here, following 2 strategies are followed by Harris-Hawks to detect the prey. First, they will check the position of their family members in the neighborhood. Second strategy is check the target position. As you can see in the real life, they can move easily from one place to another place. But in this algorithm, we will use certain mathematical models to update the position. So how we can update the position for the Harris Hawks in the search space using this mathematical model? Here, this is the position vector. And this is the randomly selected hawk from the current population. This is the target position. Here you can see this one is the average position of current hawk's population. Here this is the current position for the hawk. And you can see here R1, R2, R3, R4 and Q. They are the random values in between 0 and 1. And T is the current iteration. Here you can see this one. And we can compute the average position of the current population using this equation. Here n is the total population size and this is the hawk current position. Here you can see we have following two strategies followed by Harris hawk to detect a prey. This one for case 1 and this one for case 2. In case 1, we can obtain the solution based on the random location and other hawks. In case 2, we can obtain the solution from group member, random position and randomly selected components. Next question is how Harris hawk can exploit the rabbit. Simple, when the rabbit energy is low, it can easily exploit or attack the rabbit. Rabbit energy decreases while he is trying to escape from the hawk. In the first phase, you can see we have rabbit energy level that is high. You can see it represents, suppose, energy level for the rabbit. As you can see, hawk is chasing the rabbit and you can see the energy level is decreasing for the rabbit. And you can see here, energy level is decreasing as it is continuously chasing. In the real life, they can move easily from one place to another place. Again, in order to compute the energy level for the prey during escape, we will use this equation. Here, E is the escaping energy of the prey or rabbit. This one is the initial state of its energy inside the interval minus 1 to 1. This one is the maximum of iteration and T is the current iteration. When this decreases from 0 to minus 1, it means rabbit is tired. And when it is increasing from 0 to 1, it means rabbit is strengthening. So how we can update the position for the rabbit in the search space? We will compute the energy and after that, we will compare it with the fitness value. And we will update the position for the rabbit in the search space. The next is how we can perform the exploitation step. We will compute the energy level and we will check if energy is greater than or equal to 1. It means rabbit energy level is higher and it can escape easily. So hawk search different reasons to explore the rabbit location. If the energy level is less than 1, it means rabbit is tired and have no energy for escape. So here we have exploitation phase, that is the attack by the hawk. So how we can perform this exploitation step? Exploration phase is performed in the previous phase. Now we have exploitation, it means the attack on the target. So in this case, Harris hawk can perform surprise attack, that is Harris hawk pack attack on the detected prey. Here we are using following four strategies that are proposed in this algorithm to represent the Harris hawk attack on the target. Each time, rabbit will try to escape from the attackers. So we have following four strategies used by Harris Hawk for the attack. First is soft roundup, second is hard roundup, third is soft roundup with progressive rapid dives, and the last one is hard roundup with progressive rapid dives. Case 3 and 4 represent the most intelligent behavior of Harris Hawk in the search space while they are trying to search and attack. As we know, in the real life, Harris Hawk is the most intelligent bird and how they chase and attack the target. So here case 3 and 4 represent the most intelligent behavior of the Harris Hawks. Rabbit will always try to escape from the attackers. So as this one is trying to escape from the attackers, so how we can show this? We are using a variable R. Suppose here R represent the prey successfully escaped from the attackers. So value for R, that is the random value, if R is less than 0.5, it means target escaped before attack. And if value for R is greater than 0.5, it means target not escaped before attack. Case 1, that is soft roundup. If energy is greater than or equal to 0.5 and R is greater than or equal to 0.5, it means rabbit has enough energy to escape from the attack, and Harris Hawk's pack will encircle the prey from the different directions, softly or hard. It depends upon the target energy level. In case 1, you can see rabbit has enough energy and it can easily escape. So in this case, Harris Hawk encircle the rabbit slowly and make it more tired than perform surprise attack. And we can represent this behavior using this mathematical model here. This is the difference factor between the position vector of the rabbit and its current location is the energy that we computed before. J is the rabbit random jump strength, and we can compute J using this equation. And here T is the current iteration, and this is the rabbit position. In case 2, that is hard roundup, we will check the energy level and R. It means rabbit is tired. If energy is less than 0.5, it means an rabbit is tired and has low escaping energy. So in this case, Harris Hawk perform sudden attack on the rabbit. And we can represent this behavior using this mathematical model. In case 3, that is soft roundup with progressive rapid dives, you can see energy level is greater than or equal to 0.5, and this one for R. It means rabbit has enough energy and it can easily escape from the attack. So in this case, again, Harris Hawk encircle the rabbit slowly and make it more tired than perform surprise attack. And we can represent mathematically this behavior using this equation. Here we can compute by using this, and here G using this. Here this is the Lavis flight, LF you can see. This is the Lavis flight. Case 4, that is hard roundup with progressive rapid dives. In this case, you can see energy is less than 0.5 and R is also less than 0.5. Here you can see no escaping chance and energy level is also low. So we have not enough energy for the rabbit to escape from the attack. In this case, we have sudden attack on the target, and we can represent this behavior mathematically using this equation. So that's all about this algorithm. First, we will initialize the population, check the stopping criteria, compute the fitness value, then set the rabbit position in the search space. And here we have candidate solution as Harris Hawk and bat solution as rabbit. And we will perform exploration, exploitation, and different strategies to update the position for hawk and the rabbit in the search space. And in the end, we will return the rabbit location and its fitness value. So that's all about this algorithm. If you have any question, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.